She is to Texas women's basketball what Rudy is to Notre Dame football. We now welcome in Helen Tao of the Texas Longhorns. Very special to have you here because your story really is pretty unbelievable. Tell me how it all started. When you come to the University of Texas, how did it start as far as the interest to be involved with this program?
Yeah, so freshman year, actually, I came in wanting to be a basketball manager just because I knew I wasn't good enough to play. And so I actually asked the old coaching staff, Coach G's staff, I guess, to if I could be a basketball manager. Twice they were like, no, we have enough managers already. And so so junior year, whenever the new coaching staff came, I was like, all right, I'm going to give it one last try. Like, if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, well, then there's, you know, got to do something else. And so I got it. I was able to become a basketball manager. And so that whole, you know, junior year, I became was just, you know, hanging out with the team doing basketball manager stuff.
What is basketball manager stuff? Because now you're a player. So what were you doing at this point a year ago?
What was I doing? Oh, man. I mean, everything that didn't actually include, like, physically running up and down the court and shooting baskets. So I guess a lot of stuff was just behind the scenes, making sure that there was, like, towels, Gatorades, making sure Coach always had all of her, you know, whistles or whatever she needed to set it up. I mean, we were there. We were on top of things. I mean, just making sure that, like, logistically things were set, everything was in place before it needed to be, you know, brought up into, you know, the actual, like, thing, I guess.
So then the off season rolls around. What's your expectation as far as what you thought you'd be doing this year?
Yeah. So this year came along and I was like, okay, well, I wanted to be a paid manager. So last year I was actually a volunteer manager just because time commitment wise, I didn't know if I could, you know, throw myself completely into basketball. I was also a resident assistant. And so I just wanted to, you know, if I was going to put myself into something, I wanted and get paid, I wanted to make sure that, you know, I did it, you know, with 100%. And so this year I was like, okay, well, I'm quitting my other job. I'm going to be a basketball manager, get paid. And so off season, just, you know, kind of doing the same stuff that I did before, you know, like last year. And then one day at practice, we didn't have enough practice guys. And so, you know, I played in high school, so I was like, oh yeah, I'll just, you know, jump out there. Why not, right? And then, you know, halfway through, Coach was just like, Helen, do you want to play? And at first I thought she was like, why are you out here? You know, like, why are you wanting to play with them? And so I was like, yeah. And then she's like, we'll dress out tomorrow. And so I was like, okay. I don't know what really that meant, right? And then after practice, though, I went up to her. I was like, Coach, so when you said dressing up, like, suiting out tomorrow, do you mean, like, were you being serious? And she's like, yeah, do whatever you got to do to be like to be a player, or do whatever you got to do to practice. And I was like, okay. And so but the thing was, this coach is so nonchalant about the way she talked about it, right? She like made it seem like it was not a big deal. Well, internally, I'm like freaking out.
You just became a member of the basketball team.
Exactly.
As a walk-on.
Exactly. Coach even did that, like, yeah, just go do whatever you gotta do, like the whole hand wave. And you're just like, Coach, this is a huge decision. Like, this impacts this whole, like, my life right now. And she was just like, yeah.
Well, then the climax of all this, you get on the court, you get some action, and against Texas State, you go to the free throw line. What was that moment like for you?
Oh, man, it was crazy. I wish I could say, like, I remember everything completely of that, but honestly, half of it is like a blur. I just, like, wanted to make my free throw. I was a little nervous because that's, like, the first time that, like, I'm, like, suited out on the actual free throw line about to, like, score. It was just crazy. And then I knew, like, all my teammates were, like, wanting me to score. So I felt like there was a little pressure right there just because I didn't want to let them down. I didn't want to let myself down. And so, yeah.
That's the one shining moment.
Exactly.